merciful love, O God, we have exceeded in the midst of your temple. Your praise, O God, like your name, reaches the ends of the earth. Your right hand is filled with sacred justice.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries.
You were sent to heal the contrite heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. O God, whose abundant grace prepared St. Henry to be raised by you in a wonderful way, from the cares of earthly rule to heavenly realms, grant, we pray, through his intercession, that amid the uncertainties of this world, we may hasten towards you with minds made pure. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of Genesis. Judah approached Joseph and said, I beg you, Lord, let your servant speak earnestly to my Lord, and do not become angry with your servant, for you are the equal of Pharaoh. My Lord asked your servants, have you a father or another brother? So we said to my Lord, we have an aged father and a younger brother, the child of his old age. This one's full brother is dead. And since he's the only one by that mother who is left, his father dotes on him. Then you told your servants, bring him down to me that my eyes may look on him. Unless your youngest brother comes back with you, you shall not come into my presence again. When we returned to your servant, our father, we reported to him the words of my Lord. Later, our father told us to come back and buy some food for the family. So we reminded him, we cannot go down there. Only if our youngest brother is with us can we go. For we may not see the man if our youngest brother is not with us. Then your servant, our father, said to us, as you know, my wife bore me two sons. One of them, however, disappeared. And I had to conclude that he must have been torn to pieces by wild beasts. I have not seen him since. If you now take this one away from me too, and some disaster befalls him, you will send my white head down into the netherworld in grief. Joseph could no longer control himself in the presence of all his attendants. So he cried out, have everyone withdraw from me. Thus, no one else was about when he made himself known to his brothers. But his sobs were so loud that the Egyptians heard him. And so the news reached Pharaoh's palace. I am Joseph, he said to his brothers. Is my father still in good health? But his brothers could give no answer. So dumbfounded were they at him. Come closer to me, he told his brothers. When they had done so, he said, I am your brother Joseph, whom you once sold into Egypt. But now do not be distressed. And do not reproach yourselves for having sold me here. It was really the sake of saving lives that God sent me here ahead of you. The word of the Lord.
Thank you.
Our responsorial song. Remember the marvels the Lord has done. Remember the marvels the Lord has done. When the Lord called down a famine on the land and ruined the crop that sustained them, he sent a man before them, Joseph, sold as a slave. Remember the marvels the Lord has done. They had weighed him down with fetters, and he was bound with chains, till his prediction came to pass, and the word of the Lord proved him true. Remember the marvels the Lord has done. The king sent and released him. The ruler of the people set him free. He made him lord of his house and ruler of all his possessions. Remember the marvels the Lord has done. Alleluia, 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 alleluia. The kingdom of God is at hand. Repent and believe in the gospel. Alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, Lord.
Jesus said to his apostles, "As you go, make this proclamation. The kingdom of heaven is at hand. Cure the sick, raise the dead, cleanse the lepers, drive out demons. Without cost you have received, without cost you are to give. Do not take gold or silver or copper for your belts, nor no sack for the journey, or a second tunic, or sandals, walking stick. The laborer deserves his keep. Whatever town or village you enter, look for a worthy person in it, and stay there until you leave. As you enter a house, wish it peace. If the house is worthy, let your peace come upon it. If not, let your peace return to you. Whoever will not receive you or listen to your words, go outside that house or town and shake the dust from your feet. Amen, I say to you, it will be more tolerable for the land of Sodom and Gomorrah on the day of judgment than for that town." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
There is so much to this Gospel today. And really, to fully get the picture, you have to step back a little bit. You may remember that yesterday's gospel were the verses just prior to this, in which the names of the apostles are given. That's important. That's an important part of understanding this gospel, too. And you have to wonder, why did Christ give these particular instructions to his apostles? He tells them pretty much they are restricted to stay out of Gentile territory and pretty much limited to Galilee. They're going to go out and evangelize to Jews. Now, this follows what they are supposed to do according to the what's in the book. There's, let me be sure that I've got that point right in my head. Following God's plan, they have to go out and evangelize to the Jews first. And getting back to the question about why did Christ give these, his apostles, these particular instructions, part of it was because these men were not very well equipped at this point to preach to Gentiles or any folks other than the Jews. They didn't have the background, the techniques. And when I say that they had to do these things in this particular way. It had to do with prophecy, the book, the Old Testament. It had to do with what prophecy said would happen. Jews had to be the first ones to receive the invitation. We all recall that. So he restricted their evangelization to the Jews. And again, why? Jesus, this was a training period for his apostles. He was training them, preparing them to later go out and evangelize the world. This vision of God's to evangelize, to convert folks from sin to grace, from darkness to light. Until now, these men could not fully appreciate that. They had been going along. They had been on this ride with Christ. He was making all the decisions. He was making the choices and direction that they would follow. At this juncture, when he sends them out, they get their first experience. He tells them what to do, but they have to make those choices on their own. It's interesting, too, that the instructions are a little bit harsh. You know, he tells them, if you're not welcomed, if these people don't want to listen to you, what do? You go outside their house or outside the town where you're not welcome, shake the dust from your sandals. You don't have time for them. It's a little bit harsh, but you know, it's the message that offer them love, offer them eternal life, and they must make a decision. And if they decide no, then you can't worry about them. You have to go on. Essentially, that's what his instructions are. These are compassionate works. They're nonverbal. They're proclamations of the gospel, essentially. There are numerous messages, as I said. This is a complex gospel today. But the one that stands out, that stood out in my mind, certainly continues to do so, is this aspect of the 12 men, his apostles. And as I mentioned yesterday's gospel, where those 12 men are identified, there's something that we know. We know very little about the 12. That's significant because the gospel is all about the work. It's not about the workers. It's interesting, though, that, and it's revealed in when the apostles are named, how different they are. Matthew, as we all know, was a tax collector. Many people did not perceive them as real good folks. They were certainly not nationalists. They were seen to be men who profited off of their tax collection. They would take kickbacks or skim off the top. And commonly, if a tax collector was in a rich place, they became rich. So they were like the opposite of nationalists. Simon the Zealot, on the other hand, is identified as a man who is a super nationalist. He's like beyond the normal person who would go to war for their society. For their nation. He's a man who would happily die for his freedom for his national freedom. Now, think about these two different men who were apostles. In normal circumstances, they would not have hung around together. They were so different. They would have been at each other's throats, probably. And they were two of the 12. The 12, which we can see, were just ordinary men. Some very different than others. Certainly not all the same at all. The message in that for us that has is tied in with evangelism too is that the church is founded upon ordinary men and women who may have very differing opinions, very differing feelings about all sorts of things. But just as these 12 learned to work together, live together, struggle together to do Christ's biddings, to do God's work, they learned through their association with Christ, how to come together. That message is there for us as well. In the big picture, they would never let anything come between them and Christ. And of course, Saint Mother Teresa of Calcutta advises us the same. Let nothing come between us and love. Peace be with you.
Coming together as one family in faith, let us offer to God our prayers and our needs.
Francis, our Pope, and Thomas, our Bishop, and all the clergy of the people entrusted to their charge, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who hold public office and those who assist them in promoting the common good, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord,
for those who travel by sea, land, or air, for captives and all held in prison, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For all of us gathered in this sacred place by faith and devotion, and by love and reverence for God, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
And for Rosalie Summerall, may she rest in peace, and for whom this Mass is being offered, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
Offering all our prayers to the Father, let us conclude with a prayer in honor of the Blessed Trinity. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands, and will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God's bread.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands, will become our spiritual drink. Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands, for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and good of all his holy church.
through the present oblation, O Lord, which we offer in commemoration of Blessed Henry, bestow on your faithful, we pray, the gifts of unity and peace through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For in the marvelous confession of your saints, you make your church fruitful with strength ever new, and offer us sure signs of your love, and that your saving mysteries may be fulfilled. Their great example lends us courage. Their fervent prayers sustain us in all we do. And so, Lord, with all the angels and saints, we too give you thanks, as in exaltation we acclaim.
Holy, 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 holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Save us, Savior of the world. For by your cross and resurrection, you have set us free. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Thomas, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead
temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress. As we await the blessed hope in the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but I'll ask the same word for myself.
Let us pray. May the sacrament we have received, O Lord, in commemoration of Blessed Henry, sanctify our minds and hearts, that we may merit to be made sharers in the divine nature through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Mass is ended. Go forth glorifying the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God.
Prayer to St. Michael. Holy Michael the Archangel, defend us in battle. Be our protection against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him when he humbly pray. And to you, O Prince of the heavenly host, by the divine power, rush into hell, Satan and all the other evil spirits who wander through the world seeking the ruin of souls. Amen. Divine praises. Blessed be God.
Blessed be his holy name.
Blessed be Jesus Christ, true God and true man. Blessed be the name of Jesus. Blessed be his most sacred heart. Blessed be his most precious blood. Blessed be Jesus in the most holy sacrament of the altar. Blessed be the Holy Spirit, the Consoler. Blessed be the great Mother of God, Mary, most holy. Blessed be our Holy and Immaculate Conception. Blessed be our Glorious Assumption. Blessed be the name of Mary, Virgin and Mother. Blessed be St. Joseph, our most chaste spouse. Blessed be God and his angels and